Hello and welcome to the online learning session Bush Control Touch Basic Commissioning. Yeah, our online learning session are taking around 30 minutes, maybe today a bit more. The focus is on a special topic or a function of a device, such as a Control Touch today. Yeah, my name is Thorsten Reibel from the ABB Competence Center Europe Smart Buildings. My colleagues Jürgen Schilder and Martin Vichari are also in their home offices, and Martin will do today the main part of this webinar. Yeah, the session is recorded and published, and you will get also a feedback email later as the presentation and also the video recording of this online learning session. Yeah, you see us here in our home offices, myself, Jürgen and Martin, and also Stefan. Stefan Grosse is taking care of the technical support. So our issue is from our home offices to your home offices. I think many of you are also working at home at the moment. Yeah, I would hand over now to Martin. Martin will continue. Just a moment, please.
Yeah, hello everyone. Thank you, Thorsten, for the introduction and also warm welcome from my side. Yeah, my name is Martin Vichari. I'm located at Buschega in Lüdenscheid, and I want to present you today basically the new smart wizard for commissioning the Bush Control Touch. So I don't want to lose too much time, so I directly start with the agenda for today. Yeah, as I said, the new smart wizard of the Control Touch will be the main topic, so we want to see how it's possible, or if it's possible, to commission the device at least with its basic functions, yeah, more or less today in 30 minutes. Yeah, the new smart wizard of the Control Touch guides us through the whole installation or commissioning process. So the wizard brings us also more or less the agenda for today. So we have, of course, a little bit of preparation, such as the registration for the device, and also we need a My Buildings account. And then we directly start with the commissioning part, which I will show live for most of the steps. So the commissioning process consists of five parts mainly. So we have to register our device, we have to create a new project, we have to create and link our group addresses, and then we create a profile, so a visualization, and then we have to fulfill some local commissioning steps. So the device we are talking today about is the Bush Control Touch, so a smart and simple KNX visualization for smartphones, tablets and Windows computers. So a very easy and intuitive navigation and controlling concept is behind there. One special point is definitely the web-based commissioning part, which we will see today. And from functional point of view, the device covers, of course, the most important functions, so the KNX basic functions like switching, dimming, blind control, RTC control, scenes, and so on, but also advanced functions like Sonos, timer functions, trigger functions, commands, we can integrate IP cameras, and so on. So a very, very powerful device. Today we will focus mainly on the basic functions and on the basic commissioning. To the part of preparation belongs also the KNX project. So the KNX project, which you use for the visualization, should be more or less finished before you start with the commissioning of the Control Touch. So of course, if you have later on small adjustments, if you want to add functions on new devices, no problem, but the main functions should be available when you start commissioning. So for today, I also prepared a small KNX project, including some switching, dimming, and HVAC functions. Yeah, so this is more or less the base which we will use for today. So what we definitely need to start commissioning the device is a My Buildings account. So most of you will know our My Buildings service, so our cloud service mainly for remote control. And with our My Buildings portal, we also cover the commissioning part. So what we have to do is we visit, of course, my buildings. And when you want to log in, you have on the bottom side a small register button, and there you can register a new account. What is important here, what we need to commission the Control Touch is an expert account, so an installer account. With an end user or an end customer account, it's not possible to commission the device. So here we put in our name, our last name, our email and so on, and this way we create our account. And after that, we can log into my buildings and we can call the Bush Control Touch. So we go to my installations, also very important, not my home. We go to my installations and here we call our Bush Control Touch. So when we go to this page, we will see all of our registered devices. If there are no devices registered for the moment, then we can just call the Bush Control Touch commissioning menu, and then we will be forwarded to this page. So this is more or less the preparation, what we have to do first of all. So we need a My Buildings account. So the second step, or the main commissioning parts, begins now with the overview of our Smart Wizard. So we have mainly three parts here. We can create new projects. We can also, of course, edit projects, or we can edit profiles, so our visualizations. Here for this online learning session, we want to create a new project, of course. So in this case, I would now click on Create New Project. And here you see then the whole process which we have to run through. So the first step would be then that we have to register our new device. So if we buy a new Control Touch device, which is not registered yet, we have to register it here. I will later on use my existing device, but for the case that you have a new device, we would register it first of all. Registration means that we have to put in now, first of all, our serial number. The serial number is printed on the label of the device on the side. So here we put in the 15 digits of the serial number in. And after that, we have to confirm one more time that we are a professional installer and not an end customer. The second step of the registration is the creation of the local user. And this is very important. So the local user is the user which I will use later on for the app. So we are not talking here about my buildings account or something like this. We need one additional user to get direct access to the device and to enter first of also, for example, the profile. So to download the profile and get access to it. So here I would always recommend to start first of all with a username like admin, installer, installation or something like this. Then of course you have to remember the password and store it somewhere on the password manager or something like this. Yeah, and after that our device is more or less registered and we can start with the next steps. So I will share my screen now, first of all. So the next step I want to show you directly live. So I hope you can already see my screen. So I'm now already logged into the My Buildings portal. So as I have explained, I have to go now to My Installations, to Bush Control Touch. And here I can find now my available devices. So I have already registered one, so I can directly open it. And I will be directly forwarded to the Smart Wizard. As I said, we want to create a new project here. And here again, the Smart Wizard, I see, okay, the blue step is the step I have to fulfill next. So everything what is gray, I can't click, I can't open it here. So the wizard really guides me from step to step. So I can't really do something wrong. So I will select here now an existing device. So I select the device which is already registered, and the first step is now already checked with a green check mark. So the first thing what I have to do now is the setup of a new project. For the project, I have first of all the possibility to import a project from a file. So when I have a local file of a project, I can import it, or I can copy from another project which is somewhere stored on my my buildings account. Here for the case, or for this example, I will create a complete new one. So I name it, for example, online learning session. And now I have some further settings. So I can first of all decide whether I want to use a date, a time, sunrise, sunset, and something like this from the control touch, which I want to send to my to the KNX bus. So here I prepared two group addresses for date and time, which are 300 and 301 for the time. And I decide I want to send them, for example, every 30 minutes. So some very basic settings, general settings for the project. I can now, first of all, save this. And now I see the second step also already finished. You can see now that two fields are blue, so I can decide now whether I want to load a KNX project, or I can also directly link group addresses to my functions of my visualization. In this case, if I don't load a KNX project, I would have to do this all manually, which is not so comfortable, so I decide to load a KNX project here. So I have to select a file first of all. Here I prepared a small KNX project with the basic functions which I showed before, and now I upload the file. So the uploading process is quite fast. We also have a short scan for viruses, of course, and after this short scan, the device is uploaded. So this takes, of course, some time, also depending on the size of your KNX project file. This will take a few seconds, but in general, this process is also quite fast. So the file is now imported, so I can again click on next, and now I go on with the linking of the group addresses to my functions. So this is now maybe the most important point of the commissioning part. So here I have to define which group addresses from my KNX project file I want to use for my visualization. So you see here on the bottom side, here we will create a list with all components. So one component also always consists of the type. So the data point type, what type I have, switch, a dimmer, a blind, and so on. We have, of course, a name for this group address, and then for this component, and then we have to put in the sending and the status group address. So the sending group includes the group address to which a telegram is to be sent, so at the maximum one group address here. For the status groups include one or several group addresses to display the status of the component. So here we can also use more than one group address. The value includes the value that is to be sent. So I, for example, if I want to use a value sender or something like this, or a value to which the Bush control touch is to respond. So this is mainly the list we have to create now, and I have now several options how I want to proceed. So I could first of all do this, of course, manually, but this is not so comfortable. As you can see here on the top, all of my group addresses which are inside of my KNX project file are imported here. So I see, for example, all my groups for lights, my switching, my dimming, my values, and so on. So I want to add now, first of all, some lights, so to switch the light on and off. How I proceed, I can now, for example, select the middle group switching. So I select the whole group, and I say here on the right side, I want to add all of this functions as a switch. Here on the top, I can also group them. So means I can decide if I want to group them by middle and by main groups, by building plan or manually. Here for me, I decide to add them by main and middle groups. So when I click now on this plus icon, you see that all components, all switch components are directly added to my component list. The same I could do now also for the whole group, so for the complete main group, or I go ahead and say now from my whole light group, I want to add, for example, some additional dimmers. The control touch will automatically find the right data type and add now also all my available dimmers to the list of components. What is important now is, of course, here we need, of course, also the right status for the dimmer. So at the moment I have two separated group addresses, one for the value and one for the status. Here I have not only the sending group address, I have also the status, means I can copy now the status group address, the one for one, also to my dimmer component, and the status I don't need anymore because both is included here to the dimmer component. So this is the way I go ahead and add now all group addresses which I want to use for my visualization. So I could also add now, for example, some values from my RTC. So for example, the actual temperature if I want to use it. So here also the control touch directly have the information that this is a temperature data point type, or I could also use, for example, the CO2 value. The CO2 value is here then, of course, no temperature. We don't have a data point type for ppm, but we could just in general use a 2-byte value here for this case. So next I can save now my configuration. So after all group addresses are now imported, which I want to use, I can show you one more time, everything is now also ordered or grouped by the main and the middle groups. I can now go on with the next step. The next step are some extra features which I can add. So here we have, of course, also a lot of different possibilities. So we can create, for example, or we can import cameras or integrate cameras, so mainly IP cameras. So when I click on add camera, you see now you have the possibility to add three different types. So in general, access cameras, mobotics, or other cameras. So for other IP cameras, it's always important to put the URL directly of the MJPEG stream. For access and for mobotics, it's important to and the URL of the device within slash as described here. So to have an example, I have, for example, the webcam of Lüdenscheid prepared, which is online and which is an access camera. So here in my history, I also have directly the URL for the webcam. I put this in, I say add, and now I can use later on this IP camera for my visualization. Of course, you could also use here local cameras, local IP cameras, then you put in the IP address of your local camera. This is, of course, also possible. So what else is possible? We have the commands. The item commands can be used to specify commands for IP devices, so to activate them, for example, or integrate them in general to your building automation system. So for example, when you have a mobotics camera, there are internal mobotics functions like sound alarms and something like this. So this can be triggered here with TCP calls or with HTTP commands. The data logger, so here you can of course create data logger values here. So for example, I have added now the temperature. I select the right component. So here heating and my actual temperature. And I can just say, okay, I want the time period hour, day and week maybe, and I add this. The same I could also do, for example, now for my CO2 value, which is also available. Again, I select the right component and I add it. So this way you can display then later on again in your visualization some data loggers. The next step would be, or the next possibility would be, to create triggers and KNX Sonos linking functions. So here I don't want to go into details today. So the next online training session on Thursday, we will go to explain this functionality in detail. In general, we can say it's possible here to link Sonos boxes, which are available in my network, to some KNX functions. So for example, to control the volume with a KNX device and so on. So this we will explain later on, or on Thursday in detail. The next option are the room thermostat controllers. So the Bush Control Touch has up to 16 master RTCs, which I can use. All in all, up to 100 RTCs can be implemented. And when I add now, for example, one slave thermostat, because I have integrated a master in my KNX project, you see here that the whole application of our room thermostat is integrated. So for the slave, I select then that is a slave device. I want to say that it's only for heating. I don't need a switch over. I also don't have a fan coil. And the changing of set values, I need, for example, a one-bind counter value. So these are the main parameters. So you see everything is imported here. And for the group objects, I also have here the full list of group objects. And here the linking is also very easy. You see here all group addresses which I have imported from my KNX project file. So I go to heating and then I just have to link the object with the right group address. This also works with drag and drop. So for the on-off confirmation, I can just drag and drop it here. The same I do, of course, for the temperature, for the fault, actual temperature, and so on. So this way I can very easy link all my group addresses with the objects of the slave here. So the set point, the request object, and the confirm object, and last also the controller status. Don't forget to save, and then we can go on with the next topic. So the scenes, the time switches, and the presence simulation are three topics which are available directly in the device. So you will see later when I get direct access to the device, I can set up my scenes, my time switch, and the presence simulation. So the main part is now finished. So our KNX, our project for our Control Touch is now ready. What is missing is, of course, the visualization, so our customer profile. So first, I can, of course, use an existing profile, or like in this case, I want to add a new one. And here I have, again, different options. I can import an old profile from from my local computer or from my buildings, for example. But what is very interesting is function auto-generate profile. So here we have the possibility to automatically generate a profile from my KNX project file. So when I click on auto-generate profile, I directly see that I have here now the name of my KNX project file. So here for this case, I will just rename it. So auto-generated and then I have some basic settings, first of all, like the color, what is the startup page and so on, what button type I want to use. So these are some basic settings which are then valid for each page. Of course, each page can then be automatically also adjusted individually. So here, this is then okay for me. I say again, change and continue with the wizard. And now I can start with the visualization. So for the visualization, you see now on the left side that already some pages are created automatically. So I have, for example, one page for my cameras, one page for my data loggers, and the rest is again the structure of my KNX project file. So I have now the basic structure, which is then the online learning session. I named it like this. And the second navigation page goes then to used, not used. So my used functions are in this case, for example, our dimmer and our switch actuator, which we have added. So you see that the structure is automatically created and also some functions are automatically created. The good thing or the advantage which I have here is that for some functions also the linking between group address and function is already there. So I would just have to rename it, for example, switch B or something like this. So give it a good name and then the linking is already done also to the right group address. Basically, what we have to do if we want to create all pages by our own is that we add a new page. So here I would like to add, for example, a RTC page where I see all my room thermostat controller. So this is in this case a control page, it's not a navigation page and also not a room view page. Room view page I will show later. For the control page, I want to use, for example, an icon for the temperature. So something like a heating icon, for example, and I save this page. Now I can add different components. So this is how you would proceed in general. So you could, for example, add now a temperature value. So display temperature, you add this, and you maybe want to see also RTC control element. So in general, you add now the components like this, very easy. Just select the right component and click on the plus. And then we have to link it, of course, also with the group addresses. So here for the temperature, I have here the list of my possible group addresses which fit to this control element. So I select here the actual temperature and I save this. For the RTC control element, it's even more easy because I have here the selection, the RTC, which I want to control. So you have here a full list of all room temperature controllers which you have created. So you select here the slave which we created. Save and again you're finished. So this is a normal control page. So as you see, the page type was control page. A navigation page is, for example, just to navigate through the different menus. So we could, for example, add now here a new page link to our navigation page and to navigate, for example, also to our RTC page. Again, we save and then we see how it would look like. The third type of page which is available is the room view page. So for this example, we select now our page where we have our switch, our dimmer. For our dimmer, we have to add now also the switching object, not only the dimming object. So we have now here the right switch. I want to have text with slider. This is okay and save. What I want to do now is change the page type. So I change from control page to room view page. And I save this and you see that the view is now changed to a tablet view where you can see now different bubbles, which I can now again use exactly like this. So I can click on them, I can select the right temperatures and so on. Same for the switches, same for the dimmer. What I need here, of course, is a background. So I click again on the whole page here on the top and you see here the image category and the image name. So images can be added via this menu here on the top left right. I have already imported some images. So you see my category here, house pics, and then I can select, for example, one of my pictures which I have added. So here I select, for example, the guest room. I click on save, and then you see how it will look like later on. So this view will be visible not only on the tablet like you see it here. This room view will be also displayed on your mobile phone or on your computer. So this is mainly how you go on and add different pages, how you create the navigation page, and of course how you add functions. So basically we add components, we link them with our group addresses, and this is mainly the process how you go on. So for my project this is now a case, so I can again continue with my wizard, and you see two points are open, which is the setup of the device and the setup of the app. So I start with the setup of the device, so I get now the hint I have to power my device, so means my Control Touch device must be installed in my network. If I want direct KNX access, I have to connect it also to my KNX bus, and then I have to set up the device. So I have to find out now, first of all, the IP address of my Control Touch device. When you don't know it, we have one small tool which is called the IP Finder. You will get a download link for the IP Finder in the presentation later on. With the IP Finder, the system or the small application is searching for ABB IP devices in my network. So here I have the Bush Control Touch and the voice control available. So I can call here the Bush Control Touch and start commissioning. Here I have to put in now the username and the password of my local app settings. So as I explained, not the my building's password and username, really the local user. So here I created a user which is called installer with a password, and I can now log in to the device. So this is the direct access of the device. Here we have again some different features available. So we see first of all, of course, the status of the device. We can create scenes, time switches, present simulation, alarm messages can be displayed, and so on. So this is more or less the really local settings of the device. Maybe the most interesting thing is of course the IP settings, so you can change between DHCP mode or not, you can give another IP address like this, so you can also use a static IP. We enable of course the remote access for the Bush Control Touch, and you can maybe activate some user logs. What else is possible and maybe interesting are the protocols. So when we go to protocols, we see UPnP is available, Zonos is available, and the KNX settings. Here I can decide if I want to have direct access via the KNX bus, or you can also use KNX net IP. In this case, we need here the IP address of my IP gateway, and this way you can also connect your Control Touch with your KNX installation. Here in my case I have direct access, so I can let it like this, and for my main settings this is now everything okay. What I have to do now is I have to load the configuration now into my device. So we have the button here load configuration, and you see that the synchronization of the app starts. So again, this takes a little bit, and after the synchronization is finished I can jump back to the wizard, and you will see then, so the synchronization of the configuration is now completed. I can go back to the wizard, and the wizard shows me now, okay, the setup of the device is successful, we have already loaded the configuration, so we can go now to the very last step, which is the setup of the app. This is also quite easy. So when you use a mobile phone, then you can select here the user which you use. So I use again my installer menu account. You see now here a QR code, and with the Control Touch app for your iOS or your Android device, you can then scan this code and the download of the app will be triggered. So again, you have to put in, of course, the password of the username and then you can download the configuration. So to show you how the configuration looks like in the end, I will use now the Control Touch desktop app for Windows. So you can see here in the main menu or in the settings that I am connected with my buildings account. I've already put in my username and my password, and I can now update the list of profiles which are available. This takes, of course, a little bit, and now I see here the auto-generated profile. So this is the profile we just created. I can select it and click on load profile, and this again takes a little bit, and then the different functions will be available here. So this is, I think, still the old one. I think we need to wait a little bit. Yeah, so now it's refreshed, and now you see I have, for example, my data logger and my temperature, which would start to log the data now. And we have also, for example, the cameras. So you see the webcam, which I have just added. So quite rainy in Lüdenscheid at the moment. You see the site for my RTC, which I can control now. You see, for example, and you see, of course, also the room view page, which we have created. So here I'm now also able to control the lights. Good. So this was mainly everything from my side. So I will stop sharing now, first of all, and then I will hand over to Thorsten.
Yeah, thank you, Martin. I think the Vidal is a very good thing to simplify the first commissioning, the basic commissioning. And I think we have seen it's not that much. Of course, there are some more powerful functions inside this component. And on Thursday, we will take care of the Sonos integration. But the first steps, which of course important, so not that much anymore together with the wizard. Allow me to come to our last slides. As always, questions we handled. Hint to all the documents, to our homepage, where you find for all products our information, including the Control Touch, of course, our training data, which also will then include the recording of these sessions, our training qualification calendar. It's a bit limited at the moment because we have no presence trainings, neither in Lüdenscheid nor Heidelberg. But we are still optimistic that we can continue the second half of this year with presence training. We will see, we keep you informed, but still planned our certified trainings. As always, in July, the advanced course, October, tutor course, and basic course, additional one in November. But we will inform you every session what is the actual status, the actual situation. But let's be optimistic for the next future. Good. We are continuing, of course, also with our webinars, and we come back to the DALI topic finally next week, and we summarize everything which is specific for these products, the KNX DALI Gateways Premium, and also some news will be there. We will go in some more details of the IBAS tool. So DALI is an important topic, and so we will just round it up with this additional webinar here. And our online learning session will be continued as well. So still on Thursday, Martin will continue with the Control Touch and these specific topics, Sonos linking. It's worth to take an own session here. And then Martin will continue with another week with the presence detector, two sessions or 2 days with each two sessions, zones, calibration and constant light control will be one. And the so-called master-slave concept, very important or very often used, will be then content on the Thursday of the 7th of May on Thursday. But more will come, so we do not stop here, and step by step we will roll out more of these sessions. Then we have finished our sessions. Thank you for your participation. Thank you and see you next time. Bye-bye. Ciao.